Now it's time for the last assignments in this final COA lab, managing instances. The first instance-related assignment is to create a private flavor with the name P1 minimal using the following settings. And we need to give the tenant production access to the flavor. Let's do this from the Horizon interface. Let's sign out and become user Anna again. Let's create the flavor from the Horizon web interface as well. So we need to create a flavor that belongs to the tenant production. So we need to create a flavor that belongs to the production tenant. You might think that you need to log in as user Anna in order to do so, but that's not the case. Creating flavors is something that you need to do as cloud admin. So from Horizon, let's sign out and sign in as the admin user. And in the admin option, we can see a list of all the flavors. And we'll create a flavor with the name p1.minimal. vCPUs is 1, RAM is 2 gigabytes, so that is 2048 in megabytes, and root disk is 5 gigabytes. And then there is flavor access, and we want to give access just to the production project. We click create flavor, and then we are done with lab assignment 5. So we can move on to lab assignment 6, in which we are going to start the instance. So in lab assignment 6, we need to create an instance web server using the Cyrus image and P1 minimal flavor and attach it to the production internal network. And also we need to make sure that SSH web as well as ping traffic to the instance is allowed. So this sounds like work that we need to do as user Anna. Before starting with the instance, I think it's a good idea to start with access and security. So it is just asking about security group, no SSH keys, no floating IPs, just a security group. So let's click create security group and call it web SSH ICMP. And now we can select manage rules and add some rules. So what do we want? We want to include ping traffic. That's done through the all ICMP option. Hop. We add it. We need to add another rule. And the other rule is going to allow SSH traffic. And we need to add web traffic as well. If the question is like this on the exam, I would really recommend you to add HTTP as well as HTTPS. So now we have a security group with a couple of rules. So next we can move on and create the instance. So launch instance. Instance name is web server. Availability zone Nova count 1, that is okay. Let's click next. The instance boot source, that's going to be an image, that's all right. And we want to use the Cyrus image. So we can click it here and click next. We need to select a flavor. So here is the P1 minimal flavor. And let's click next. It needs to be on the production network. Let's click next. Network ports are not needed here. Security group is needed. We need web SSH ICMP. And that's all. No, that's not all. We still need to add the volume. But the volume apparently is not in here. So to associate the web volume to the instance, we need to go somewhere else. So for now, we can click Launch Instance. As you can see, no options here to add the volume. And we can see success, one instance launched. The status is currently set to build, so we need to wait a minimal amount of time. We can see the IP address, and the instance is still spawning.
To here.
And oh no, we got an error. So let's read. Failed to perform requested operation on instance web server. The instance has an error status. Please try again later. And the error is no valid host was found. Now that's an interesting one. And I even think I know what's happening here. Let me show you. First, I want to sign out from this and I want to log in as admin. Because it's complaining about no valid host, right? So, being admin, I can check on the hypervisors that are available. And we can see that the hypervisor is available. We've got a memory usage of 1 GB out of 3.7 in total, and local disk usage, and vCPU usage, 2 of 1. So it's pretty busy. vCPU is over-allocated, in fact. So that's a compute host, and we can see it as hypervisor host as well. So apparently there is a hypervisor available. Let's have a look at instances as well. And we can see that some instances are available as well, including the failing instance that we have just launched. So we can delete this instance. I can do that as admin because I'm cloud admin, right? And I have permissions to do that. Now let's get back to the production tenant environment. And let's repeat what we have just done, because we will see that the explanation is in there. So we have just clicked Launch Instance. So the instance name is Web Server. I'm going to call it Web Server 2 just to avoid any slow synchronization preventing me from having another error. Then we have the source, which was Cyrils. And next we selected the flavor. And that's why we've got the problem, because this flavor wants too much. 2 GB of RAM is never going to work because my hypervisor node has just a little bit over 2 GB of RAM available. If we allocate 2 GB of RAM to this instance, then the hypervisor node doesn't have sufficient memory anymore for hypervisor tasks. And that is why it's complaining about no hypervisors available. Nova is telling us that it couldn't find any hypervisor that meets the criteria that are posed by this flavor. So instead of the P1 minimal, I'm going to use the M1 micro. And then we do next and we click the production subnet and next again. And we don't have network ports. We do need the security group. And with the security group, we can now launch the instance. And let's wait and see if it's doing any better now. And there we can see it is now running. So now we can take care of the last task in this assignment. And that is the volume. As you can see from the drop-down list, there is no option to associate the volume. That's from the volume list. So we go to volume, there is the web volume, and if we click the drop-down list, there is managed attachments. And manage attachments, from this drop-down list, we can select the web server instance. We can select the web server instance, attach volume, and then it mentions attaching volume web to instance web server as, what was that, a VDB. And there you can see it is now attached to the web server as a VDB. Isn't that cool? Let's get back to the instance. Not because we need to, but just because it is interesting. Open link in new window. could have done new tab, and let's do a console. Click here to show only console. Yes, yes, we know, not private, we don't care. So now that we have successfully associated the web volume to the instance, we are done. And this lab assignment is over. I hope the COA exam is as easy as this lab.